guys and new subscribers. So, I am not in the best mood today, to be fully honest. I'm angry and I'm really, really, really pissed off. So I need a distraction. My foster kitten just died like a couple of hours ago and I couldn't really do much about it. I don't know why I decided to go back to college to become a vet, because every time an animal dies, it just takes a huge toll on me and I cannot get used to it. And since I'm not really in the mood to be inspired and excited, I decided to go with Kim. I know a lot of you guys have warned me about this song, but I feel if I'm ever gonna vibe with this song, it's gonna be now. Because according to your comments, I feel this song is more on the angrier side of Eminem. So fuck it. Let's react to Kim today. Without further ado, let's get started. Running like a Hellcat. I don't think there's a music video for this song, so I'm gonna be reacting to the lyric video. So, in 3, 2, 1,
go! Oh, look at Daddy's baby girl. It's Daddy's baby. Oh, sweetie, head. Yesterday I changed your diaper, wiped you and powdered you. How did you get so pink? Can't believe
baby it. Talking.
Hey, but you're so precious. Daddy's so proud of you.
Sit down, bitch. You move again, I'll beat the shit out of you. Don't make me wait for the baby. She don't need to see what I'm about to do. Quit crying, bitch. Why you always make me shout at you? How could you just leave me and love him out the blue? Aw, oh, what's the matter, Kim? Am I too loud for you? Too bad, bitch. You're gonna finally hear me out this time. At first, I'm like, aye, you wanna throw me out? That's fine. But not for him to take my place. Are you out your mind?
Well, that kind of took me off guard, because at first he was baby talking, I'm assuming Haley. And then when he started screaming, I thought he was screaming at the baby. I'm like, no, that cannot be him. By mistake, he was addressing Kim. Obviously, the song is called Kim. But the transition was very abrupt. Can you blame me? All right, when I said the angrier side of Eminem, I think that was just a little bit of an understatement, right? Okay, let's continue.
Are you out your mind? This counts. How could you let him sleep in our bed? Look at Kim. Look at your husband now. I said, look at him. He ain't so high now, is he, little punk?
Why are you doing this?
Shut the fuck up.
You're drunk. You're never gonna get away with
this. You think I give a fuck? Come on. We're going for a ride, bitch.
No.
Sit up front.
We can't just leave Haley alone.
Wait.
What if she wakes up?
We'll be right back. Well, I will. You'll be in the trunk.
Wait a minute! Okay, conspiracy theory. Okay, this cannot be real. This cannot be real, because according to the lyrics that I'm reading, this is very hypothetical. This is like metaphorical for his pent up rage, right? Okay, quick recap. Kim is ugly screaming. Eminem killed the boyfriend that she's cheating with. And now he's shoving her in the trunk and planning to kill her as well. Yeah? That's it? Cool song. Okay. Also, this is giving me deja vu. I reacted to an Eminem song, Stan. And when Stan was driving off in the very heavy rain, I remember I reacted to the censored version, so I wasn't really aware that his girlfriend was in the trunk screaming. Is this correlated to that? Maybe. Now. Okay, the chorus was pretty quick, but the way he like stretched out, elongated the words, gave them like a chilling vibe. One thing I need to say, and maybe I'm being presumptuous over here, but this relationship is so damn toxic. I've reacted to, I think, 2 songs that Eminem mentioned Kim in, and me being a completely oblivious person, just picking up on lyrics, this gotta be one of the most toxic love-hate relationships. Just say.
Really fucked me, Kim. You really did a number on me. Never knew me cheating on you would come back to haunt me. But we was kids then, Kim. I was only 18. That was years ago. I thought we
Jason! What are you doing? Change the station! I hate this song! Does this look like a big joke? There's a f***ing road to them. They get dead with a split throat in your living room! Ha ha! What, you think I'm kidding you?
You loved him, didn't you?
Bullshit, you bitch! Don't fucking lie to me! What the fuck's this guy's problem on the side of me? Fuck you, asshole! Yeah, bite me! Kim! Kim! Why don't you like me?
Okay, rewinding. I got. There's a 4-year-old dead in the. Wait. I did not catch this properly. Wait, I'm rewinding.
Few moments later.
No. Just a theory. Did Kim remarry and have a little boy? Or maybe the lyrics are wrong. Okay. Eminem over here is just batshit insane. I don't know, when he said haha, it kind of reminded me of the Joker for some reason. He's giving me such chaotic, vengeful vibes. Wait! There was a beeping, 3 beeps, and that asshole beside him, like in the car. Okay, I might be totally wrong, but it's kind of like the scene in Stan. I know Eminem leaves clues here and there. Maybe the two songs are overlapping somehow? Let's continue.
You think I'm ugly, don't you? It's not. No, you think I'm ugly. Get the fuck away from me. Don't touch me. I hate you. I hate you. I swear to God, I hate you. Oh my God, I love you. How the fuck did you do this to me? How the fuck did you do this to me?
The way he's screaming the lyrics and his frustration, I can actually feel it. Really upsetting to listen to. Okay, I don't know how much this is true to the reality of this situation, but I don't know, to me, it's really sad when a person is neglected love. They tend to reflect that on their own self-worth. The root of the problem is me. That's why I am not worthy of love. God knows I know how that feels. But Eminem, actually everyone, I'm saying this to everyone. Know your worth. Ow, my hands are freezing. I mean, I know, right then and there, at the spur of the moment, it'll feel like the world is ending. Because why the fuck the person you love most doesn't love you back? And as much as you're angry with them, and as much as you think you hate them, you still love them. And that's what drives you mad. That's what kills you. Because you thought that this person would never, ever, ever do anything to hurt you. Yet they did. So yeah, I really get this anger, but I feel, I'm predicting over here that he'll come to the realization at the very end that she's not worth it. Fingers crossed.
Come on, get out! I can't, I'm scared! I said get out, bitch! Let go of my hair! Please don't do this, baby! Please! I love you! Look, we can just take Haley and leave! Fuck you! You did this to us! You did it! It's your fault! Oh my God, I'm cracking up. Get a grand marshal. Hey, remember the time we went to Brian's party and you were like so drunk that you threw up all over Archie? That was funny, wasn't it? That was funny, wasn't it? See, it all makes sense, doesn't it? You and your husband have a fight. One of you tries to grab a knife, and during the struggle, he accidentally gets his Adam's apple slice. And while this is going on, his son spoke up and he walks in. She panics.
By the way, who is Archie? I need to know. Please mention it in the comments down below. And over here, is he trying to frame her? He's making up this story to basically hide his tracks that Kim is actually the murderer, and I think that's why she committed suicide. And I'm just hypothesizing over here, she threw herself off a bridge. I'm overlapping the storylines of the song and Stan. And also, I just noticed that along with his storyline, he actually did kill a 4-year-old. His son just woke up and he just walks in, she panics, and he gets his throat cut. Okay, so Eminem, or whoever is the lead in this fucked up horror story. Killed both the husband and his kid. Double homicide. Okay, cool. Let's continue.
Now they're both dead, and you slash your own throat. So now it's double homicide and suicide with no notes.
I just heard that!
When you started to act weird, we could have. Hey, where you going? Get back here! You can't run from me, Kim. It's just us, nobody else. You're only making this harder on yourself. Haha, gotcha! Go ahead, yell! Here, I scream with you.
Okay, it's like watching a horror movie, I swear to God, but in song form. Okay, my predictions were false. She commits suicide not via jumping off a bridge. She also slashes her own throat. And we're at a point where she was able to escape, she ran away, but he managed to catch her again. And he's actually kind of mocking her while she's screaming, because obviously he planned this well. He took her to the middle of nowhere. Pretty damn sure nobody's gonna find them.
Don't you get it, bitch? No one can hear you! Now shut the fuck up and get what's coming to you! You were supposed to love me!
The sound is
bleed, bitch, bleed! Bleed, bitch, bleed! Bleed!
This is intense.
Bitch, you did me so wrong. I don't wanna go on living in this world without you. So
graphic, but not visually. Very explicitly put along with the sound effects of the choking. And this could easily be the soundtrack of an investigation discovery show. Inside the mind of a murderer. Kind of shit. You guys were right, this song is a tad bit too extreme. Really giving me murder documentary vibes. So tonight I'm definitely gonna Netflix and chill and not sleep at night. I didn't know it's just the melody because there was a minute left. Wait, what? What is that sound? Is that a chainsaw? No. Wait. What is it? Was he like going through a forest and removing the plants and the trees? Or maybe he's dragging her body across like the plants that are giving off this screeching kind of sound, places her in the trunk and shuts the trunk, cause I kinda heard in the background like a car passing by. Yeah, he's on a highway. Holy shit, that was so smart. That was so creative. If you don't know, I'm a really huge fan of investigation discovery and murder documentaries, that kind of shit, so that's why I got a little bit too invested. But damn, that was such a nice touch. I've never really witnessed that in a song. That was original, yet very chilling at the same time. Okay, I just want to say that I do not condone domestic abuse. I know this is metaphorical, but still, no matter how fucked up a bitch is, violence is not the answer. I need to put that out there. And I feel this is a given, but also murder is not the answer. And hopefully anyone who has this type of dark thoughts will never, ever act on them. And again, I know these are just lyrics. They're nowhere near the truth. They're trying to portray a story. Still, it needs to be said, definitely. Did not expect to react to such song. I've never seen the side of Eminem. This song really showed me how Eminem is such a layered person and very versatile. So far, I've witnessed Eminem be vulnerable, a great father, inspirational, a comedian, a badass rapper, and really the list goes on and on. And what's so cool about all of this is that he managed to portray each side so brilliantly. So if this is it for this reaction video, guys, I really hope you enjoyed it. And as always, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you like my channel, please subscribe. And if you'd like to support me on Patreon, make sure to hit that Patreon link. See you next time. Bye.